Okay, here's where I'm at right now. Getting close to finished. But I went back and re-examined what this thing's supposed to look like. I watched the dragon pit scene again and got this screenshot of Jon Snow's knife. You can see the top edge of the knife is a lot straighter than I thought it was. And the tip isn't as swooped as I thought it was either. And there's a big, pointy, dangerous thing at the base of the dagger, right where your hand is. Probably end up stabbing yourself with it, but I'll wrap some leather around the handle. So I did the final drawing. This is the first one, what I thought it might be. I was being a little too conservative. And definitely too much going on in these edges. Then the second one, I kind of toned things down a little bit, made it longer. I had to adapt along the way. And this is what I came up with in the end. I think that'll be manageable. More of a straight edge here. Slight belly comes in, and then there's a nice point there. I think I shouldn't get the tang any thinner than this, but I have to bring it in quite a bit from here so that it can line up well with the point, with the tip. Okay, I think I'm gonna do the rest just with pressure. I want to do some final shaping, setting up the edges for the final pass of pressure, which will just sharpen the edges. I don't have enough space to play with here to do nice parallel pressure flaking passes everywhere. I just want to worry about balancing the edges as much as I can and then getting them sharp. Then I'll worry about the handle. So after parts 2 and 3 in the series, I took the night off, got in a fight with a rose bush, trying to prune it back. I dressed up my pressure flaker too. It's rainy and a bit windy today. Hopefully that doesn't doesn't affect the sound too much. That was a nice little pass there. 1, 2, 3, 4. That was a big one. It blew up the last part of that, the last flake there. It might be one of the biggest pressure flakes I've ever taken. It's a beauty. Big pressure flaking, little tool. I wouldn't mess up on the tip right at the end, eh? that really saved that. There was a big bump forming in the middle there. Just got rid of it all. Straightened everything out very nicely. No, didn't get it. That'll have to be in the final product. Well, that got some of it, actually. That got the rest. Cool. This thing's getting really close to finished. I think I'm pretty happy with that as a final shape. Maybe I can fix up the tang a little. Okay, I think I'm happy where this thing is right now. I'll do the final sharpening when it's attached to the handle. I didn't want to get too fancy with the edges, put too much waviness into them. I decided on a nice kind of traditional knife shape. I don't know if that would be a Bowie knife or something else. But I got a halfway decent pressure flaking pattern on most of it. It's really good right here. There's a bit of edge waviness still in there, but I can get rid of some of that with the final pressure flaking pass. Okay, I'm just gonna make the handle. Alright, I'm just gonna make the handle now using just stone tools. I know in Game of Thrones they've got metal tools, but I am prehistoric living after all. I just use natural tools no matter what I'm doing. Alright, let's get this done. Alright, let's get this thing done. Alright, let's get this done. Alright. Alright, let's get this thing done. Alright, let's get this thing done.